gentlemen, brothers, sisters, comrades, friends, here's my proposition. What we have here, picked from no mean source, is a distillation of precisely what is twisted and immoral in the faith mentality. Its essential fanaticism, its consideration of the human being as raw material, and its fantasy of purity. Once you assume a creator and a plan, it makes us objects in a cruel experiment whereby we are created sick and commanded to be well. I'll repeat that. Created sick and then ordered to be well. And over us to supervise this is installed a celestial dictatorship, a kind of divine North Korea. Exigent, I would say more than exigent, greedy for uncritical praise from dawn till dusk, and swift to punish an eternal, unalterable judge, jury, and executioner against whom there could be no appeal, and who wasn't finished with you even when you died. However, let no one say there's no cure. Salvation is offered. Redemption, indeed, is promised at the low price of the surrender of your critical faculties. Religion, it might be said, must be said, would have to admit, makes extraordinary claims, but though I would maintain that extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence, rather daringly provides not even ordinary evidence for its extraordinary supernatural claims, to insist that we are created and not evolved in the face of all the evidence. Religion forces nice people to do unkind things, and also makes intelligent people say stupid things. As the great physicist Steven Weinberg has very aptly put it, in the ordinary moral universe, the good will do the best they can, the worst will do the worst they can. But if you want to make good people do wicked things, you'll need religion. Religion, in fact, any form of faith, because it is a surrender of reason, it's a surrender of reason in favor of faith, is a fantastic force multiplier. A tremendous intensifier of all things that are in fact divisive rather than inclusive, and that's why its history is so stained with blood. Crimes against humanity, crimes against womanhood, crimes against reason and science, tax upon medicine and enlightenment, all these appalling things. There is no conceivable way that by calling on the supernatural, you will achieve anything like your objective of a common humanism, which is, I think you're quite right to say, our only chance of, I won't call it salvation. Thank you. No seconds left, ladies and gentlemen. I've done my best. Believe me, I have more.